I grew up in Atlanta, Georgia, and I went to Henderson High School, and then after that I went on to the Air Force Academy and graduated in 1987 with a degree in astronautical engineering. And then follow-on education from there, I completed in 1997 at Georgia Tech, Georgia Institute of Technology, a master's in electrical engineering. Why did I become an astronaut? It's a good question. It's one of the things that I remember. I was about five when the landing on the moons happened, and I remember my parents. It's kind of my first memory of television, of black and white TV. My parents calling me in and you know, getting me up to watch the first moon landing with Neil Armstrong. And when that happened, I just remember that's one of those things that when you're a kid, the way you think about things, and as you get older, you kind of, you know, you sit back and dream about it. And it was my first mission. I flew on STS-126, which was on Space Shuttle Endeavour, launched November 15th, 2008. We went up to the space station. The space station at the time only had three of the big solar arrays there, actually. So we did four spacewalks. We called them EVAs to basically lubricate that joint and allow the mission that followed us actually added on the final array in its final configuration. So that was a big part of our mission. My second mission, I flew on STS-133, which was on Discovery, and I was honored to get the chance to fly the last space flight of Space Shuttle Discovery, which is now in the Smithsonian Institute. And Discovery, at the end of the mission, flew 39 times in space and actually accumulated 365 days on orbit. And on the final flight of Discovery, the MPLM had been modified to be a PMM, permanent multi-purpose module, and we actually physically attached it to the station. It's up there now. We also brought up Robonaut 2, R2, that's on board, and we had it was a good chance. It was the last three missions of the space. We started it. Discovery came up next, then was Endeavour, and then we finished off the space shuttle program with Atlantis on the final flight. We have 16 partner nations that are working, and we have other nations involved in the science and other things. And bringing this world together, I think, is one of the big parts of the International Space Station. And I think the future of exploration is going to rely on countries working together to get to these far places. Because to go to Mars, to go to other planets is very expensive. I think it's important as a world that we get together and work on projects to go to places.